Zarin standing by before tip-off.
Well, thanks, George. You know, he could be out up to 2 weeks, but right now, as he will all through tonight's game, Allen Iverson is receiving in the Pistons training room a variety of treatments for his ailing back. And on non-game days, if you're over at the practice facility, getting treatment under the watchful eye of that man, the strength and conditioning coach, Arnie Kander. Arnie says Iverson won't travel with the team, but tomorrow, for example, when they are in Atlanta, yeah, he'll be back here getting treatment. It is an unspecified problem, but Arnie says backs are fluky and can be problematic even when tests can't pinpoint the exact source of the pain. Iverson, as you perhaps recall, crashed into a Miami player in the first half of the game 10 days ago and played through it. That was in Miami before leaving in the first period the next night in New Orleans after Arnie couldn't loosen him up. The good news is that Iverson seems most accepting of becoming the team's new sixth man, as he said in a statement that he released yesterday. That's the good news. Some of the sobering news that you touched on our pregame show, George, is the diagnosis for former Piston coach, the great Hall of Famer Chuck Daly. And please, people missed the pregame show, fill them in now on what you told them. Over to you.
Thank you, Eli. Well, Daddy Rich himself, the man who probably did more for Piston basketball than anybody else, diagnosed with pancreatic cancer, receiving treatment down at his home in Jupiter, Florida. That's his winter home. You know, the Motor City is still his summer home. That's my favorite Chuck Daly pose right there. The man who made Piston basketball big time. You look at that Hall of Fame coach and those two Hall of Fame guards. Greg, those were the good old days.
No question about it. When the news came across today, I think it just really, really devastated so many people in the basketball community, George, not just here in Detroit, but all around the country. And we certainly wish him the best. And our thoughts and prayers are with his family.
Please, fans, Chuck, in your prayers. He's certainly in ours. Tony Turioff misses the first shot of the game. Rodney Stuckey misses the second shot of the game. Jamal Crawford with the basketball. Upcoming doesn't get it, but Rodney will be hit with a foul on the knockdown of Crawford. This game's available in crystal clear high definition on Fox Sports Detroit HD, sponsored by Comcast.
You know, some of the small things to consider when you're playing the Warriors, you know, you have to take good shots against this team because bad shots become fast break opportunities for them. You know, and they will not worry about the shot clock on their end. Trust me, if they can get 100 shots up, they will.
You are right about that. The pause here. The officials can look to see if Jamal Crawford was in front of, on, or behind the long line. How many free throws does he get on this foul? Well, that's pretty simple, too. Salvatore can take a look. The new rules this year allow that. And the stoppage of play, they can get it right away. Vote for your Pistons McDonald's player of the game tonight. Use your cell phone, text Pistons, followed by a space, then the player's uniform number to 74499. Check your text response for a special offer. It gets you a free four-piece McNugget with any extra value meal purchase. Already, Rip Hamilton with 63% of the early vote. 2-0 Warriors on the two Crawford free throws. Go-and-go move by Tayshaun. Pitches it outside to Rodney. Pistons go baseline to Rip. Clock at 5, gets to the elbow, fires, and fills it up.
Pistons took their time that time working against Golden State's zone. And this team will zone more than most.
2-2. Bellinelli with a shot is wide. Good challenge by Rip. Rodney Stuckey on the run to Rip. Wide open gun short. Off the floor. To Kurz, he'll screen for Bellinelli. Near steal by Rodney, and now it is a strike. Went for the jam, got it blocked.
That was a pretty
big time defensive play by Long Anthony Randolph.
Yes, indeed, and George, I think Rodney Stuckey would have been better to lay that up instead of trying to dunk it. Dunking it kept it in his hands longer and gave Randolph a chance to recover.
Crawford misses, though, and the Pistons bring it back their way. We're tied at two. Dice against Kerr. Step back gunning. It's long. Turi off with a rebound. They say at Notre Dame, Kerr is a blue guy. They don't have this year on their basketball team. And we got a bump and a foul called on Rasheed here.
Here's Stuckey. Now watch what happens when he elevates. The ball is still in his hands, still in his hands. Right now, if it's on the glass, then that becomes a much difficult shot to block from behind. As much as I love the dunk, sometimes the layup might be the better choice.
Good call, Greg. Missed by Crawford. Still 2-2. 9.5 to play in the first. Dice is open. He hits it. Went back to the timeline to get it. Kurz is open. Turi off, rebounds the miss. Kurz takes it inside, can't convert. Rebound Rasheed. Dice gets a run on Turi off, missed on the reverse. Campbell for the rebound. Roni Turi off. Took it away from young Anthony Randolph. Deep bounce to Turioff from Crawford for the deuce. It's 4-4.
That's how Turioff can hurt you. He'll work on the glass. He'll play defense. He'll clog the middle. But if you can get in close and they get him the basketball or work off the offensive glass, he can go beyond the 4 points a game that he averages on each night.
Warriors just 1-for-7. Ooh. Whistle blew and Dice took his eye off the ball. Passed him right in the forehead. He's all right.
Here's where a couple of Warriors go after a rebound. Now, right now, we don't know who has it. The statistician's waiting. Okay, give it to Turioff.
Meantime, three in the lane without guarding called on Kurz. So the Pistons get a free throw and another possession.
If this were football, George, you could split that rebound like a sack, right?
Exactly. 5-4 as the 88% free throw shooter Rip Hamilton knocks the free throw down. Back door. Misfires in traffic. Crawford to forecourt. Crawford gunning, doesn't get it. Tayshaun the other way. We played just over four. Pistons lead them 5-4. Tayshaun fires and fills it up. Tayshaun and Dice each with a deuce. Rip has three. Pistons lead by three, 7-4. Bellinelli wide open, triple. Marco Bellinelli, the 18th pick in 07 by the Warriors.
Looks a little like Manu Ginobili, doesn't he?
Yes, he does. Hey. Shots on the jam. Challenged but fouled.
Call the 31, Rob. He is first. Team first.
This is why you never take your eyes off the ball, folks.
Yeah, a moment ago the whistle blew, so Dice looked away.
Get in there, Hope.
That had to hurt.
It rattles you. It rattles your head a little bit. Now, of course, since it happens in front of a full house nearly, you play it off, George. You don't right. Let them know you were jarred a little bit there.
Back in the backyard, you might stop for a minute.
Oh, yeah. And complain to the person who threw it.
Thank you. Tayshaun's two free throws. On the Kerr's foul, make it 9-7 Pistons. Kerr takes the pass, gives it up to Randolph. Turioff with the shot. Off-iron and out of bounds.
Detroit basketball.
Golden State 2-for-10. Pistons with 9 shots up. 3 of them went down. Lays it up, lays it in.
That's beautiful. Richard Hamilton moving while the ball was in the air, so it was almost like a touch pass from Rasheed, and Rip was not about to miss that layup.
Warriors barely had it swiped and saved by Rip, but it'll be Golden State's ball. Take a look back.
Rip's going to come off the screen. He'll then pass it to Rasheed, who's posting, and immediately make his move to the basket. Watch, he's gone. And the pass is right there. Moving without the basketball. We showed you in the open how well Rip has been doing that.
Golden State just got a dynamite dunk from Turioff. I'll give you the laundry list of their out of uniform players tonight in a moment. Andres Biedrich, the fifth leading rebounder in the league, normally starts at center. Turioff comes off the bench. Sheet over Turioff. Greens the deuce, Pistons 13, Golden State 9. Crawford from downtown drains it. Crawford with 5. Golden State's within 1. Rodney Stuckey, stop and go. Hit in the paint and the whistle will blow. With 5:42 to play here in the first. The foul is on Turioff. Here's Sheet scoring over Turioff. Timeout at the Palace. All right, thanks. Somebody doing a hit here? Or we just... We're at the Palace. Pistons and Golden State about halfway through the first. The Pistons with a 1-point lead. Chuck Daly, one of those. Who's had a number retired here, 2 for his back-to-back NBA championships. It was announced today that Chuck is fighting pancreatic cancer, and this statement from Joe Dumars virtually says it all. He certainly does hold a special place in our hearts, and all of us will support Chuck Daly in any way we can. Just like a punch in the stomach when you hear news like that about a guy like that.
Exactly. You know, you really just don't know where to go with it, George, but you know, Chuck was he's a strong man, and I know he'll do all that he can.
Yes,
I'm
he will.
Certain of that.
Rodney Stuckey with a pair of free throws. Pistons 15, Golden State 12. Crawford gets a screen from Kurz. Kurz gets it back, bounces to Turioff. Crawford jumps into the jumper. In and out to Rasheed. Pistons caught a break there. That was halfway down. Tayshaun gives it up, gets it back, hooks it up, hits it. Count that, baby, and a foul.
You know, oftentimes a team that loves to run is a good team to run on.
Yep.
And you can see the Pistons pushing it. Golden State not as zealous in their effort to get back on defense. And the Pistons able to victimize them on that play.
Turioff just committed his second foul. He rebounds Tayshaun's missed free throw. Pistons lead him 17 to 12. Lonnie Turioff looks at the basket, fires long. Dice with a rebound. Looping feed to Tayshaun. Rips open. He hits it. The triple for the Piston captain gives him 8. And the Pistons lead by that many.
Pistons still finding the open man, playing simple basketball. Get open, get the ball.
Good jumper there, got nothing but net. Anthony Randolph, the 14th pick in this year's draft. After one excellent year at LSU. Scorer, rebounder, shot blocker at the collegiate level. And he'll do that here soon. Tayshaun's miss, a run out by Golden State. Rebound comes to Rip. Fourth court to Tayshaun. This was easy, laid it up, laid it in.
Wow.
8 for the Palace Prince. Pistons lead by 8. Randolph's miss, pulled down by Rasheed. Dice baseline gunning. Turioff with a rebound. 6 boards for Roni Turioff. Bellinelli's shot is short. Robbie still with it, challenges Kurz and draws the foul. Kurz now with 2. To match Turioff's total. Golden State almost out of players. We mentioned there's no Andres Biedrinch here. No Kalena Azubuike because of a back. Monte Ellis with a family issue. Steven Jackson with a hamstring. Corey Maggette with a sprained right ankle. Brandon Wright with a dislocated left shoulder. They're all out. They can all play. This week, NASCAR on Fox moves to Atlanta, where Kyle Busch is the defending champ. Coverage of the Cobalt Tools 500 from Atlanta Motor Speedway begins Sunday at 1:30 in high def on your local Fox station. Rodney missed a pair of free throws. Still 22-14. This guy can shoot it, but that one won't go. Young Anthony Morrow, undrafted out of Georgia Tech, leads the league in three-point shooting at 50%. And there's the laundry list right there. No Steven Jackson, no Andres Biedrinch, no Ellis, no Azubuike, no Corey Maggette. I didn't mention him.
You know,
and that's a big loss as well.
Well, you said it best. All these guys can really, really play. And they've had more different starting lineups by far than any other team in the league due to all the injuries. And Georgia league rule mandates that you have to dress 8. So they've got 3 guys on that bench, but only 2 available with Jackson out. Jackson had to dress so that they could adhere to league rules.
And now they've got foul trouble. Kurz already has his 3rd. He just put Dice on the line. Dice now with 4. Pistons lead by 10. They're on an 11-2 tear. Kurz with a 3. Scramble for it on the baseline. Ball boys get run over. Maybe a photographer. Out of bounds to the Pistons. 3:02 to play in the first. Pistons with a 24-14 advantage. Sheen working against Kurz. And Louis Grillo blows the whistle on Anthony Morrow. And we'll get a whistle for a timeout now with 2:51 to play here in the first. So far it's been all Pistons. They lead Golden State by 10.
My favorite actress. Okay.
Hi, this is Kwame Brown asking you to join us Wednesday night when we take on the Knicks. It's the 2009 Pistons Telethon, and this year we're teaming up with Feed the Children. That's Wednesday on Fox Sports Detroit. Please help us help those who need it most.
And at a time when so many people are in need, the Pistons Care Telethon hopes to put a lot of food on a lot of tables, and we need your help. Please join us. And Kwame Brown's a guy who cares about the community. Nice to have him on this basketball team, joining a lot of other guys who are community involved. There's the big guy. Let's take a look at the Pistons' upcoming schedule now. Courtesy of Best Buy, we'll fly out tonight, play at Atlanta tomorrow. Could be a first-round playoff preview. Orlando's in here on Monday. That could be a first-round playoff preview. Then the Pistons Care Telethon game against the Knicks, a very exciting team. Off to Toronto, and then home against O.J. Mayo and the Memphis Grizzlies Sunday afternoon, March the 15th. Ripped with a pair of free throws. Pistons now lead 26-14, a 13-2 run. Swipe, they'll find him. Lays it up. Lays it in, and he will go to the line.
Will set his man up beautifully. Waited for the right moment to just pick the pocket of Anthony Morrow, George, who is not ordinarily a ball handling point guard who's out there setting up the offense. You can tell he was a little pensive with the basketball.
Oh, tough spot for him to be in.
Yeah.
The free throw makes it a 16-2 run. Randolph nearly turned it over right there. Oh. Gives it up to Bellinelli. Oh, can really shoot it. Off the dribble, though, not his forte, and that's in and out.
See, the Pistons are
much better on catch and shoot.
Absolutely. The Pistons did a nice job of making several of the Warriors go to their weakness, which is like Morrow off the dribble or Torrey off in 16
feet. Jason Maxfield in the ball game. So he makes his presence known, as did Will Bynum. The turn and gun makes it 31-14. It's an 18-2 Piston run. And Louis Grillo will blow the whistle on the Pistons here. Jamario Davidson will check in for Golden State. He was signed in January after playing out a couple of 10-day contracts. Last year was Charlotte. Second round draft choice out of Alabama.
Oh,
whoa! Will Bynum foul. Time for a Meyer scouting report on Jamal Crawford from the University of Michigan. Great deep shooter with the Knicks, traded to Golden State, and he struggled some from behind the long line. 31%. That's our Meyer scouting report on Jamal Crawford. Want to send a happy 60th wedding anniversary wishes to Dean and Sally Hartley from Rochester. They're watching tonight on their anniversary, and they do bleed Piston Blue. We really appreciate them. Happy anniversary. Piston inside. Jason flips it up and fills it up. He has 10. It's 33-16. Both shot short.
That was because it was challenged and he was forced to have to alter it and shoot it on the way down.
Pistons are playing very well on both ends.
Yes.
As we talked about in our open, not just offense. Greg underlined what they're doing defensively. Davidson pulls off the rip miss. 42 seconds to play in the first. Crawford with a drive. Loaded up there, I thought, for Randolph. Well, lands in Bellinelli's hands. His pass inside for Randolph's out of bounds. That's a pained look on Don Nelson's face. Crawford, 1 for 7. If ever was a night you needed Crawford to go for 35 or 40, it's tonight.
Yep, you're right.
About 3 seconds difference, shot clock to game clock. Rip behind the back, shot is wide. 4.8 seconds to play in the first. Crawford's pass, right by Will Bynum. Shot off the glass and hit the iron at the end of one. The Pistons, who streaked to the finish line with a 20-4 run, lead the Golden State Warriors 33-16. The Pistons trying to win their fourth straight here at the Palace. You're watching Pistons basketball on Fox Sports Detroit, presented by Bell Tire. Love for 22. So we have a season high for points in a first quarter. Oh my gosh. He's been watching these games too long, tell him. Zero turnovers.
K Pistons basketball on Fox Sports Detroit is brought to you by Caesars Windsor, the life you were meant to live. Caesars Windsor, and by your Chrysler and Jeep superstores.
Good times at the Palace tonight. Our first quarter statistics are presented by your Chrysler and Jeep superstores. 22% shooting for Golden State. Pistons shot 50%. They're up their most points in the first quarter yet this season as they take a 33-16 lead here to the second. Walter Herman on the floor. Kwame Brown, Jason Maxiel, Will Bynum, and Rodney Stuckey. Walter with the corner gun. Jason Maxiel with the offensive board. Pistons get still another crack. Will Bynum floats it up. His own rebound knocked away from him and out of bounds by Davidson.
Pistons were trying to exploit a matchup down low to have a guard on Jason Maxiel, but you know what, George? You're going to have mismatches all night long, so you don't really have to come out of your element to go after it. You can just flow into it. Yeah.
Will Bynum against Morrow gets Bynum. Mario Davidson to Randolph. Morrow with a shot. This is another. Pistons tried to lob it deep to Jason Maxiel, and he drew the foul.
On Jamario.
Jamario Davidson with the foul. Here comes C.J. Watson.
C.J. Watson now.
Second-year point guard from Tennessee, non-drafted player at 17 back in November against the Pistons. That's our Meyer scouting report. C.J. Watson. Bynum now with five as Will's jumper goes. Pistons lead 35-16. Watson, Bellinelli, Randolph, Davidson, and Morrow for the Warriors. Bellinelli with a drive, doesn't finish. Rebound out of bounds off Kwame Brown. Here's who's on the floor, presented by Wallside Windows. Talked about the Golden Staters. Pistons with Rodney Stuckey, Kwame, Jason Maxiel, Will Bynum, and Walter Herman. Morrow's shot swatted. Rodney Stuckey dishes to Walter Herman. Short on the long gun. Jason Maxiel had the rebound, knocked away from him and out of bounds by Morrow. Until halftime, Pistons lead 35-16. Rodney Stuckey fires and fills it. Weak stroke right there for Rodney. 24-4, that's the run. The Pistons are on right now. Whistle blows. Will Bynum, that's his third. He doesn't want to come off, but he'll have to. Aaron Aflalo will check in.
No drop off, that's for sure. Aaron Aflalo coming in. I'm sure he's anxious to get some good things going. He's lost some playing time due to the elevation of Will Bynum in the lineup.
Watson still with it. Davidson with a shot. Off the rim to Walter Herman. Golden State now shooting under 20%. Benny Salvatore.
That's a three-second
call.
Golden State basketball.
On Kwame Brown. If you look at Michael Curry, flanked by Darryl Walker and Pat Sullivan. The Pistons find assistant coaches. It's 37-16. Pistons lead it. Davidson put it down, nearly lost it. Morrow gets it back. Watson for three. Another clanger. Rodney Stuckey. steps back and fires it, fills it up. This run keeps on running. It's a 26-4, and Golden State will turn it over. This will blend right into a timeout with 8:54 to play in the half. Rodney Stuckey with the last two on a 26-4 Piston run.
I'm talking about Will Bynum. You have to Will Bynum VO. Will Bynum. Yes. Okay, good. Okay, I gotta remember that. Fire. See Will Bynum, and the Pistons have a sizable lead, and I find myself rooting hardest for the guys who need a break, like Bynum, whose career clock is ticking at age 26, and he needs all the playing time he can get. And lately, with Allen Iverson out, he's been getting a chance and taking advantage of it, like in Boston Sunday with his 3 steals and 9 points. Play is the easy part. It's the 25 games he didn't play at all that weighs in a player's mind. Will says, my mom, fiance, and daughter keep me grounded. Love and I believe that good things happen to good people, but I'm a pro and know all about the game's ups and downs. With this chance now, I know that the most aggressive man wins out. That has been my mentality and my style my whole career. Keep driving, young man. We're pulling for you. And by the way, George and Greg got a great feature coming up at halftime on Will on the Caesars Windsor Halftime Report. Back to you.
I had the chance to be part of that feature, and I'm looking forward to seeing it air for all of Will's family and fans. He is a good, good guy and a player. Side shot off the iron. Here come the Warriors, who are on a scoring drought. They've missed 13 shots in a row. One blocked there by Jason Maxey on Randolph. Our Caesars Windsor halftime report includes that feature on Will Bynum, Greg's game plan, and a visit with the Piston coaches. Randolph at the line. There's a great web special for Monday night's game against Dwight Howard and the Orlando Magic. Get seats at a great price and contribute to next Wednesday's Feed the Children telethon. The first 10,000 fans on Monday receive collectible photo cards of Antonio McDyess and Rip Hamilton. Visit Pistons.com or call 248-377-0100 for your ticket.
I'm looking forward to that game. The Magic will try and break a two-game losing streak against the Pistons. George, they've won 44 games this year, but the Pistons remain in their heads.
Pistons inside to Kwame Brown. Davidson called for the foul. Kwame at the line. Important reminder, tomorrow night's game in Atlanta will be on Fox Sports Detroit Plus. Coverage begins with Pistons Insider at 6:30. We have listed some of the Fox Sports Plus channel numbers here. For a complete list, go to foxsports.com/Detroit. Pistons basketball on Fox Sports Detroit Plus, presented by Bell Tire. Tommy got one. We have big free throws in Orlando and in Boston.
Sure did.
It's 40-18. Golden State, 13 misses in a row. And that's the end of it. Crawford with the rainbow gun. But he is 2 out of 8. Pistons lead him 40-20. They have doubled up the Warriors.
Well, by taking their fast break game away, making them work in the half court with this lineup, it's proving very difficult for the Warriors.
They get a fast break here on the swipe that Anthony Randolph started. He finishes with a stuff.
The Pistons haven't been very helpful for the Warriors. You know, they're taking really good care of the basketball. It's just their second turnover in the game.
Rodney Stuckey with 8. To the paint, Crawford. With our friends at Chevy help us out with our points in the paint. The Pistons with a 12-6 advantage in points in the paint. And Flalo with a foul. Crawford at the line.
Jamal Moore shooting for the wall.
Welcome Ray Antoon to the game tonight, a contributor to the For the Kids Foundation. He and friends enjoying some special treatment tonight at the Palace because of their generosity to that very, very worthy cause. There are free throws for Crawford. And the Flower with the triple try, and it's through for three.
Advantage of a reluctant Warrior zone defense that would not come all the way out to bother the shot. Nice to see Aaron get that first one to go down.
Davidson used his length a little bit there. 6-10 helped him score. Golden State. It's 47-28 Pistons, halfway through the second. And a foul fires. Jamario Davidson with a rebound. Comes Jamal Crawford. Crawford with a shot off the heel. Davidson had it, lost it. Pistons hustle it away. Rodney Stuckey, no look to air on the foul. Deeper to Jason for another jam. 49, Golden State 28.
Yeah, he's sharing the basketball very well on the Pistons.
I'm out, fight. Randolph goes down inside. And they'll call the foul on Kwame Brown. And we'll get a timeout. A chance to look at one of this season's very best dunks, Greg.
Randolph had no chance whatsoever.
Time out at the Palace.
Wow.
He punished the rim. Pistons lead of 49-28. Very good. Thank you. Why is that man smiling? Because all he wants to do is win. He loves the way the Pistons are playing right now. Antonio McDyke.
You know, I guess right place at the right time. You know, I think, you know, unselfishness. We just going out there knowing, you know, when we on that floor, we need to get baskets, get buckets, and we just being unselfish, just playing basketball, not worried about nothing. I think the most important thing is that we having fun.
And he is having a good time.
Looks like it.
Nine different Pistons have scored. Nine Pistons are in the Joey Richardson scorebook. Only eight Golden State Warriors are in uniform. I want to invite you to a very special fundraiser and award ceremony tomorrow between 4 and 8 p.m. at the Park West Gallery in Southfield for Wayusi Usola, the organizer of the Anti-Gun Violence Youth Group, Pioneers for Peace.
He's a
survivor of gun violence, but now he's battling cancer. Tickets are available at the door at the Park West Gallery on Northwestern in Southfield. Very cause for him. Hand it to Randolph makes two free throws. By the Pistons, and Swami's pass to Walter Hellman too high and gets away. Pistons 49, Golden State 30. DJ Watson with a basketball for the Warriors. Morrow gets it. Davidson. Two on Kwame. Pistons are in the penalty with 5:01 to play in the half.
Penalty situation.
Now we're in Detroit line number 25. Check in for Kwame Brown.
You know, George, after several games against division leaders, you know, it was a good time in the schedule for the Pistons to get a team like Golden State, a team that's struggling a little bit to find itself, trying to get healthy. But it still remains important that the guys out there on the floor play hard, play smart, because the toughies come right back in your face.
Amir tried to save it off. Davidson that stepped on the mound. 11 of the 12 Pistons in uniform have played. Walter Sharp, the only Piston who hasn't stepped on the floor here in the first half.
I hope we get a chance to see it. Did he look good in the Delta corner? Certainly on the green end zone.
Yeah. That's his job, yeah.
From the bench over there. And Jason thinks he can dunk anything that's in the key. You know, the key is pretty wide and long. But watch where he is, George. He goes up, he and Amir fighting for it. Jason comes away with it, and then he's trying to dunk it.
That would have been something. Two to five. On Davidson. Hey, the Knicks visit the Palace this Wednesday on Feed the Children Telethon night. A great offer on the web. You can get seats to the game and contribute to the telethon. Go to Pistons.com, or as always, call our famous phone number, 248-377-0100. But hustled it down in the corner.
No other way to explain how Jason Maxfield is shooting.
Courtney to Jason for the jam. The alley-oop flush. And the Pistons lead it 51-31.
He earned that because he certainly kept hustling after the missed free throws. Jason Maxfield.
Crawford trying to save for over the back. The Wilder hit him by hand. He dunks. Don Nelson's taking a timeout. The Pistons are having too much fun at the Warriors' expense. It's now a 53-31 Palace lead. Walter Herman with a steal and stuff. Timeout, Golden State.
It truly tells the story. It's coming right after this.
Oh, give me some updates on that. No, I won't put them on the air.
Right there. Yeah. You have 10. Okay. You want me to take it out? All right.
And I do too, Greg.
Hey, George, you want to see some hustle?
But you're talking about Jason.
Absolutely. Watch him go get this rebound over in the corner. He's going to outrun and out-hustle the Warriors to it. Now the Pistons will reset it, and Jason Maxfield will stay involved. He'll come down, set a screen. When the Warriors come off, both guys will go after the guy coming off the screen. Jason will then back cut to the hoop for the beautiful alley-oop. Look at that. Both guys go to rip. And Jason's able to sort of go back door and catch the flush.
Yeah, he's putting on a show tonight, and the fans are loving him.
That's it. Rick Aplica was on the ball when he came off that screen. But the perfect timing by the Pistons for the playing well. Again, both ends of the floor.
Watch it drive for Golden State. Inside for Randolph. The rookie's half hook. And he can't hit it. Walter Herman on the run.
I'm sure Don Nelson is very appreciative of the guys who are out there in uniforms, giving it what they can. It's not unusual to see a teammate struggling, playing up to their expectations later on in the season like this, having injuries, really just overtake things.
We've got the injury bug to train tonight. And shoot from behind the long line. As I told you earlier, he leads this league for the
2 minutes remaining until the half.
Yeah, if only he had enough, he'd be. I think he would be qualifying here. But he's got him in there. Jason. Like I said, when you saw his shooting motion.
Jason Maxfield.
He's got great stroke. Jason Maxfield. With his name in life for the number one. Jason with 10. Spurs with the hoop for Golden State there on the drive. 57-38.
Got more at the top of this, but I just wonder if he
Rodney Stuckey just took it to the rack. What he does best, and he has 10. Second-year Piston guards team up there.
This is a bad time to catch the Pistons if you're going to stay. You know, their defense is kicking. Bad is one again. They're playing solid Pistons basketball. And you can see it by the score.
Turnover Golden State.
Here are the Pistons. Rodney Stuckey in, able to scissor between two or three Warriors, and then on the transition game, Aaron Aflalo on the finish. Looking in every department right now.
Rodney has 5 assists. This one is out for Jason Maxiel. Well, the record kept it alive, but Paul has it. Bellinelli with a shot. Out of bounds.
Out of bounds. This is basketball.
Bellinelli and Kurz. Watson and Morrow, and Anthony Randolph on the floor for Golden State. There's Rob Kurz there. There's Watson. Pistons with Rodney and Aaron Aflalo, Jason Maxiel, Walter Hammond, and Amir Johnson. Closing seconds, first half. The Pistons with a big lead at the pass. 5 seconds, 4. Rodney Stuckey fires and fades it up with 2.3 to play in the half. Golden State trying to go all the way down the ground. The shot at the horn counts, says Bennett Salvatore.
Did he shoot that from behind the backboard?
I think he did. We got string music, but the Pistons got most of the first half points, didn't they? The Pistons at the half lead the Warriors 63-40 here at the Palace.
Okay. Yeah, I did speak with somebody about that. So we'll talk about, you want to talk about the lead in the, you know, we'll look at it in the break or something? Okay. Okay. Wow. My goodness. Is that the shot we're coming? Is that the shot we're coming back with? Pistons have a big lead at the half. What is that? against me when I was playing in the 3-on-3 Hoop It Up tournament here at the Palace a couple summers ago. Windsor halftime report. The Warriors get a bucket at the buzzer, but the Pistons are running away with it so far in the first half. 63-40 your score. The Pistons tying their season record for the most points they've scored in a first half this season. Hi, everybody. I'm Mickey York. The Pistons have their three-game winning streak on the line tonight against a team that has lost 12 of its last 14 on the road and is really thin on the bench. The Warriors missing six players from their roster here tonight. For their thoughts on the game so far, we welcome back George Blaha and Greg Kelser. And George, you'd figure it would be just a matter of time before the Pistons started to wear the Warriors down. It looks like that's already happening.
Yeah, this Golden State team doesn't have enough personnel to play with the Pistons. But one thing I thought, Greg, in the first half was the Pistons still played very hard, executed extremely well, and really took it to Golden State. I think probably all they had to do was show up to win this game, but they're doing way more than that.
Yeah, they understand that they can't let up. I mean, this might be a little drop in the schedule as far as, the challenge is concerned, but it gets very difficult right away again for the Pistons with Atlanta and Orlando. I like what they're doing tonight. They came out taking care of their business and putting it to Golden State, injury depleted or not.
Well, that 26-4 run did the Warriors in, and let's see how that relates to Greg's game plan now.
Well, you take that fast break away, and they really, really struggle to score in the half court. Pistons have not allowed them a tremendous amount of attempts from the three-point line. They've knocked down three, and I think the Pistons are definitely taking advantage of their size inside, working them on the glass, beating them up in the paint. George, it all looks really good right now if you're the Detroit Pistons.
A lot of things going well. The Pistons have five first-half steals. Will Bynum with two of those. You're looking at one right here. The steal and the hoop. A feature on Will's up next.
Will Bynum stretches to oh, but there's been nothing small about his play when given the opportunity.
Will has the skill level of being just a backup where he can play minutes every day. So whenever he's been asked to play consistent minutes, he stepped in and played tremendously well for us.
Will's job all season has been to be ready on a moment's notice. So when Allen Iverson left the New Orleans game with a back injury, he stepped right in. Since then, Will has slashed, dashed, and played some stout defense in the Pistons' recent three-game winning streak.
And the most of his opportunity or something will be the roll cue.
Pistons basketball on Fox Sports Detroit is brought to you by your Motor City Dodge dealers and by Meijer, the official super center of the Detroit Pistons.
Welcome back to the Caesars Windsor Halftime Report. It's the Pistons by 23, 63-40, your score at the break. Well, he may not be the answer, but he's certainly a part of the equation. With Allen Iverson out the next couple of weeks, Will Bynum's role has increased significantly. He's already scored 5 points in 5.5 minutes of work tonight, which is all part of his plan to make the most of his opportunity.
Will Bynum stretches to measure 6 feet tall, but there's been nothing small about his play when given the opportunity.
Will has the skill level of being just a backup where he can play minutes every day. So whenever he's been asked to play consistent minutes, he stepped in and played tremendously well for us.
Will's job all season has been to be ready on a moment's notice. So when Allen Iverson left the New Orleans game with a back injury, he stepped right in. Since then, Will has slashed, dashed, and played some stout defense in the Pistons' recent 3-game winning streak. And with AI scheduled to miss another 2 weeks of action, Will is looking forward to a more increased role.
It's a great opportunity for me. You know, I've been blessed to be in these kind of situations, you know, where I've worked hard, you know, the whole time, you know, I tried to stay positive, and the opportunity just came for me, you know, just like that, and you know, I was ready.
But playing with purpose is nothing new for Will Bynum. After bouncing around the NBA's D League, and after a short stint with Golden State, he found a temporary home in Tel Aviv, Israel, where he played the past 2 seasons. Being the world traveler has the 26-year-old experienced beyond his age.
I always tried to stay positive. You know, growing up in Chicago, you know, it's tough. You know, you go through hard times, you turn the corner coming home, you know, from school, and you know, it's just a gang on that corner, so you can't go that way. So you have to walk all the way around the block, you know, just to get home. It's just making these kind of decisions, you know, in life. You know, that's always kept me focused and positive, you know. And, you know, I've been patient. And, you know, my time has come now. You know, I'm just trying to take advantage of it.
So far, he has a little man getting bigger minutes, and he is indeed making the most of them. The Pistons have put together a pretty good first 24 minutes here tonight, leading the Warriors by a score of 63-40. When we come back with that big first half lead, how do they stay sharp in the second? Eli Zarrett checks in on the Pistons coaching staff next.
Walker, you know, you're beating this team handily. They're under important play in the back situation.
Well, the most important.
And welcome back to the Caesars Windsor Halftime Report here with assistant coach Darrell Walker. You know, you're beating this team handily. They're undermanned as well you should. Is the advantage that Aaron Aflalo and Walter Hermann get important playing time, especially in the back-to-back situation?
Well, the most important thing is really we play the way we're supposed to play. Don't go out there and think this is some type of a playground game, because it's not. It's still an NBA game against NBA players, and it's important that we execute offensively and defensively. That's what we've been doing so far.
You haven't. Is there a chance we have a Walter Sharp sighting in the second half?
Hopefully Walter has a chance to get in if we can keep this lead and keep building on this lead. But it'd be great if we can keep doing it, because our starters can rest, because we do have a game tomorrow against the Atlanta Hawks, and we haven't beaten those guys yet, so it's time that we get one.
Thanks, Coach. Appreciate it. That's Darrell Walker. This is the Caesars Windsor Halftime Report. George and Greg with a call of the second half coming right up on Fox Sports Detroit. Just be seeing center court here, right? Oh, here we go.
Now watch this. Watch this, Eli. Watch this, Eli.
Whoa.
Look at the girl's
eye. She is on fire.
Well, she likes you.
Whoa.
The guy is. Tell Eli the guy is really.
Man. She's kind of a poor man Suzanne Scorich.
I don't know what she said.
Tying me down? Oh, and forcing me? Please.
You think she said, do you think I used to like him? Or do you think she said,
she did kind of favor
Suzanne. I'd say very well. The Pistons do pretty much what they wanted to do in the first half.
Yeah, nice to see, but they need to just continue to play hard, hope that they can parlay it over tomorrow night.
Take a look at our first half numbers here and what's been a runaway so far. Dodge halftime stats show Golden State held a 32% shooting. Pistons crushing them on the glass, 31-18, including 10-3 in the offensive glass, 25-10 off the bench, and they have tied a season high for points in the first half for 63. They broke the season high for points in the first quarter with 33. With a spinning gun, in and out, Curry's with a rebound. Crawford, Davidson, and Bellinelli start the second half for Golden State. With the shot, Mario Davidson tried to hook it back, couldn't hit it. Pistons up 63-40. As we get the second half going here. Short. Bellinelli with the basketball. Ravens at Cam.
Davidson.
So I think if you're the Pistons, this is a good time for you individually to play, you know, a little mind games with yourself, Georgia. You know, if you're Rodney Stuckey, you know, act like, you know, tomorrow night you've got Bibby. So you want to maybe do a little scouting and preparation in this game. Even though this game still matters, it's still important. But you can start thinking ahead, and that helps you stay, I think, in good form and in good habits as you finish this out.
Dave's got a hand on Dyson's shot. On the Pistons.
Warriors basketball.
A game available in crystal clear high definition on Fox Sports Detroit HD, sponsored by Comcast.
You know, to the interior guys, think about blocking out because it's certainly going to be important tomorrow night.
Oh, yeah. Good and getting better. Bellinelli with a drive. Hooked it up and hit it. 63-44. Crawford with a rebound. Jamal Crawford still with it. Rodney Stuckey with the basketball for the Pistons. And his second rebound. He has 12 points and 5 assists.
They're still playing. They score the first 6 points of this third quarter.
Jamal Crawford. That's his Michigan high in the game of 15. He finds Rasheed, who is fouled, trying to flush it. Let's get a McDonald's player of the game voting update, sponsored by the Big Mac. I'm loving it. Rip, then Tayshaun, then Rodney. Final results post-game on Pistons Live. Check your text response, by the way, for a special offer that gets you a free four-piece McNugget with any extra value meal purchase. Anthony Randolph with the foul. Shoot, 5 rebounds. That's just point number 3 as the free throw falls. Got them both. Pistons 65, Golden State 46. Just over 8.5 to play here. Jamal Crawford working against Rodney Stuckey. Crawford on the wing for 3. And they get a whistle. Down goes Crawford.
Follow 3, Rodney Stuckey.
Rodney got him.
Second.
He's going to shoot 3 free throws.
Jamal.
I don't think they're going to have to look at this one. Guilty of getting a little contact right at the peak of Jamal Crawford's jump.
2.
First 2 have already fallen to make it 65-48. Almost bound to be a low in a game like this with the team with a big lead, and I think the Pistons found themselves in one right now.
Yeah, that's always a challenge, especially when you get the break. You didn't have to get the halftime break. You could probably keep pulling it on, but you get a chance to calm down, cool down, and then you have to try and pick that intensity back up. It can be a little difficult to do.
Rip with a shot. That ends a 9-2 Golden State run. Rip with a dozen. 67-49. Pistons. There's 2 in the quarter. Mario Davidson with a shot, and he sticks it.
Very nice on that shot. Confident, no hesitation. Smooth, right into the stroke.
There he was. Pistons by 16. Rip trying to get 18. Free from Bellinelli, who grabbed him and fouled him.
Wood. 10 seconds.
Ball's in.
Two team fouls on Golden State. Rip from Rodney, gives it back. Rodney drives it, guns on the run. Jamario Davidson with a rebound. Crawford, full court to Bellinelli. Go and go drive by Bellinelli. They push it to Randolph. Bellinelli gets it back, shot clock at 10, ripping his face. And the Pistons get a takeaway. Tayshaun with a throwdown! A dozen for the Palace Prince. Pistons lead him 69-51.
Couple of perfect alley-oop feeds in this game from Rodney Stuckey. Remember in the first half he was able to catch Jason Maxfield for one, and that one a little bit tougher, George, because it was on the wall.
Bellinelli just got a screen from Davidson. The shot down, Jamal Crawford got him the ball. Bellinelli with 7. Pistons by 16. 6-37 to play here in the third. Rip looking for a dice screen here, swiped by Bellinelli. And now loose ball foul. Called on Bellinelli. His second.
Here, Rodney Stuckey keeps his dribble until the very moment when Tayshaun Prince had made his move to the basket. The angle was perfect, and he was able to get a comfortable pass up there for Tayshaun Prince to handle.
Machine screens, and that's an offensive foul, says Vince Salvatore. Rod Bellinelli a little, and Bellinelli acted out a lot.
Well, he helped sell it. And that's the part I think he really, really hurts Rasheed. It was a sell job.
Crawford with a rainbow three. Rasheed with a rebound. Rip tried to get it ahead to Tayshaun. Finally did. The hard way. Tayshaun with the dribble. Shoots a pass to Rip. This for three, and it's through. The triple by Rip. That's it out to 72-53. Bellinelli gives it up to Davidson. Jamario Davidson way short of the jumper. Off the rim to Rip. Tayshaun. Around and off. Rebound Davidson. Jamario Davidson to Anthony Randolph. 22 to play in the third. No, but there's the follow-up flush.
Mario.
Jamario Davidson. Davis. 72-55. The Pistons lead Golden State. To get through in the lane without guarding, called on Curry.
Pistons timeout.
And we'll get a timeout here. 4:55 to play in the third. The Pistons lead 72-55.
Possible to put into words all that he's meant for this franchise?
I don't think so. I think he, like few people that you meet in your life, you enjoy him while you're with them, and when they're gone, and I just mean when they leave the organization, you look back and you say, gosh, I just wish we could do it again. I just wish I could have appreciated it even more than I did when it was happening.
Is that the cut you're going to use?
I like the cut before where he enjoyed being Chuck, even though he used it on the pregame.
It's an entertainment experience. We ask you to kind of any disruptive behavior, such as fighting, throwing objects, attempting to record and interrupt the play, or using improper spectators engaging in such behavior. Subject to objections and arrest, reporting the violations of these rules to the nearest usher, security, or guests of the staff member, and enjoy the rest of the game.
Welcome back to the Palace, 72-55. The Pistons lead Golden State on a very, very sad day. It was announced today that Chuck Daly is battling pancreatic cancer and taking treatment in Florida. And it just doesn't seem right that the Pistons' own Daddy Rich has a serious health difficulty. Tom Wilson talked earlier today.
Is it possible to put into words all that he's meant for this franchise?
I don't think so. I think he, like few people that you meet in your life, you enjoy them while you're with them, and when they're gone, and I just mean when they leave the organization, you look back and you say, gosh, I just wish we could do it again. I just wish I could have appreciated it even more than I did when it was happening.
Well, we did appreciate Chuck Daly, but Tom's right. Probably didn't really appreciate how much he did for this organization until he stepped away from coaching. Our prayers are with Chuck and with his family. I know he's going to keep fighting. Keep there. Makes it 73-55. Drives it, misses, follows it up, no. And as Rasheed taps, the whistle blows. Anthony Morrow called for a second foul.
Shooting 2-4, Detroit. Two stools for France. Take it.
Tayshaun gets the first. Nails the next. 75-55, Pistons by 20. 4.5 to play in the third. Bellinelli along the baseline. Inside for Randolph. Against some live legs, they got up and couldn't tip it in. Pistons overthrow Rip. Off the high glass.
Well, right there you just got a snapshot of what Golden State really likes to do and what they do well. Force the turnover and then attack and score quickly. Fortunately for the Pistons, there hasn't been much of that tonight from Golden State. Points in the paint, favoring the Pistons by 10.
Rip! Tayshaun!
Tayshaun with a hook and it has 16. He's got Keanu, 6'10", rookie from LSU.
He looked like he knew what he was doing on that play. Able to dribble it right into his comfort area and hoist. But we haven't seen much of running Trujillo since the first quarter of this game. So I wonder what the story on here is. The Warriors are down to 6 players.
That's just 10 minutes. Rick now with 18 with a jumper. Crawford
off to Hill.
It'll be the tip basketball.
Mario Davidson.
And we're going to timeout.
Two and a half to play here in the third at the Palace. The Pistons in the first half had themselves a 26-4 run. They keep on cooking. This is Pistons basketball on Fox Sports Detroit, presented by Bell Tire. Turn my mic on, would you? I didn't hear the count back from well, all of a sudden I did when you just said, do you hear me? Is it the wrong button?
I got the answer.
I'm sure Eddie can figure it out if he were
the
here.
The answer is that he's had a little bit of a knee injury. It didn't necessarily flare up, but he thinks the coach has given him the rest of the night off, seeing what the state the game is in.
That's Toria?
Yeah.
As you watch Automotion perform, the Pistons with a 20-point lead. How about our National City primetime performer, Rodney Stuckey. Rodney right now with a dozen, plus he has 8 assists, Greg.
Well, I like the things that Rodney has been able to do out on the floor. He's pushed the basketball. He's attacked when the time is right. He's passed it well, a couple of nice nifty alley-oop feeds to his teammates. A lot of balance on his part tonight.
And look at that number 2-3 steals in his 31 minutes so far. He dishes to Riff there, missed the shot, Crawford with a rebound. Rodney Stuckey. Up to Morrow, rebound out of bounds off Rasheed with 2:06 to play here in the third. Well, it's off Golden State. Rodney and Rick, nice take shot on Rasheed on the floor for the Pistons.
Anthony Morrow.
Anthony Morrow called for the foul, his fourth.
Richard Rick, how about shooting for Detroit?
Rip at the line. Great web special for Monday night's game against Dwight Howard and the Orlando Magic. Get seats at a great price and contribute to next Wednesday's Feed the Children Telethon. Visit Pistons.com or call 248-377-0100. 1-for-2 for Rip, and what's up for Ronan Turioff? Eli Zarrett has a report.
Well, he's had a bit of a knee problem of late, and the feeling is that Coach Don Nelson has just sat him down for the rest of the game, seeing the state of the game, so he'll have to be better prepared for the games down the road. So that's the best we can figure. Ronan Turioff injured, not enough to lead the game, just the coach's choice. George?
Well, thank you, Eli.
So, George, they are down to 6 players. My, the Golden State Warriors.
Jason Axel return. Antonio McDonald.
Golden State goes to Milwaukee tomorrow night. And then they finally go home. With a nice move inside.
Random.
And
Oliver Sheba
score the goal. Fouls on Rasheed.
CJ Watson.
Watson for Crawford.
Jamal Crawford.
With a minute and 40 to play here in the third. Rob Kerrs and Crawford.
Take advantage of that very thin area right there. Gets by Morrow. Protected the ball quite well with his body. And look at that roll.
Rip with 11. Make it 12 here in the third. 22 on the night in 23 minutes. As he knocks the free throw down. 83-62 Pistons. Just over a minute to play in the third. Tapped up though and in by Randolph.
Anthony Randolph.
53 seconds to play here in the third. Rodney Stuckey tried to alley-oop with the Tayshot out of bounds.
Yeah, that one was going to be tough because they had it snuffed out. And that's a lot of length. They're alley-oop over when they see it coming.
Ah! Still going. Misfires. Ah. 20 seconds to play here in the third. Pistons lead 83-64. Rodney Stuckey drives Watson. Attacks the ball.
So the Warriors beat the clock to finish the first half with Anthony Morrow, and they beat the clock to finish the third with Marco Bellinelli. But the Pistons have a big lead as we head to the fourth. Did you have your hand on the, were you ready to talk to me for a little while? Is that why late in the third, it's my one earpiece went away, and I thought maybe because you had your hand on the. Yeah. Did Eddie leave?
Pistons basketball on Fox Sports Detroit is brought to you by Bell Tire. Trust us, we'll make you happy you came in. That's a promise. And by Bud Light, with just the right taste that never fills you up. The difference is drinkability.
Now, not all the great dunks are made by the players on the floor. There's the Piston flight crew. A little slow-mo for you on that throwdown.
That's my man, Glenn. One of the best in the country.
Good job, Glenn. Time for a game recap. Good job, Glenn. Presented by the Romani Eye Institute. Golden State dressed just 8. Rip Hamilton has scored 22, 12 of those in the third. Jason Maxia with 10, 5 out of 5 from the floor. He's had his share of dunks, but one was almighty. Randolph to the lane. And a whistle. And a foul. For the foul. Golden State actually outscored the Pistons in the third, 26-22. The Pistons had those huge quarters, 33-30 in the first half.
Yeah, that set the pace for the Pistons and, you know, put them in a position where, you know, they could do a few extra things and maybe get a few extra people out there. Some playing time in the second half. Curry had to love the start to this game by his team. Oh, yeah.
17 at 7 of those in the third. Jason Maxey is just there. Rounding off his first miss of the ball game. First minute, fourth quarter at the Palace. Romney Brown with a rebound.
George, the ball's cut off a little bit. Yeah.
He wants to do things he doesn't do as well as he can shoot from there. Pistons lose it inside. Watch it on the run. Nice steal by Will Bynum. Well, he does that for a living.
He really reads the eyes of the ball handler. Just at the right moment, he's able to step into the passing lane.
Let's hop it. Let's rip somebody, yeah. Will Bynum on the run, behind him to Cormie. Michael Curry really doesn't like this sloppy play here. It's 10-34 to play. The Pistons have owned this one. They're going to stay sharp and go to the minor tomorrow night. That at Boston? Yep. Boston leads by 11. Okay.
Try and find either Stuckey on the bench or Joe in his, is Joe in his suite? Yes, they're off mic. Stuckey and Joe. Yes. Oh, I'm sorry, say it again, what? Yes, it worked out very well. I'll tell you about it later, okay. Diane listened, she was very pleased. Okay. rookie Walter Sharp hoping he gets a cameo tonight. You know, no sports quip was repeated more than old Yankee Yogi Berra. He was mired in a deep slump, getting advice from everybody. Then he struck out, walked back to the bench grumbling, "I can't think and hit at the same time." Well, Rodney Stuckey was starting to see the wisdom in old Yogi's absurd observation otherwise. Till last week, he too was in a slump, fretting, trying to get out of it. Finally, Joe Dumars took him aside and said, "Man, just play. Trust your instincts. Don't think so much." Stuckey says he needed the reminder and the assurance that everybody makes mistakes. It's in practice when you repeat, you reflect, and analyze. But apparently, in the game, you can't think too hard to play point guard at the same time. Greg, you know that more than the rest of us.
Oh, yeah. Eli, I know exactly what Joe is talking about. You play this game on instincts.
Anthony Carr with a shot in and out. We'll find him with a rebound.
You have to think the game, but when you're playing the game, it really has to come to it naturally on instinct, because the minute you start trying to think, you slow down, and that's when you miss things.
Now Patricia. Bellinelli with the foul. Bellinelli. Barbara Bradley, a great heckler who left us. Thinking about Chris Ford, I'll get to that in a minute. On the floor presentation, presented by Walls, right window. Tayshaun, Jason, back here, Carmi. We're buying him a lot of stuff. Chris Ford thinks so much out there, he's got a headache after everything. But he said that in a good way. Jason Maxfield with a dozen. Oh, with the floater. 87-70 Pistons, 9.5 to play.
Point blank catch. Time to power that up. Put the onus on the defense to have to stop you.
Anthony Randolph. DeMarco Bellinelli for Golden State. We've got a lot of people tonight in the draft game.
I think they would have possibly have been better with the four that didn't dress. Left the other eight in street clothes.
Man, Andres Biedrant, Elena Azubuike, Monte Ellis, Steven Jackson, Corey Maggette, and Brandon Rice all out for Golden State.
That's a lot. You said the best deal. They can all play.
They're the guys that are not here. Steven Jackson has the flu. Biedrich and Ellis going for personal reasons. Illnesses in the family. Azubuike with a back injury. Maggette with ankle injury. Brandon Rice missed over 20 games now. He's got left shoulder.
Guess it ain't tonight because you have to.
And that shot wide. Pistons by 17. 8:15 to play. Side, no, but there's Jason for the game. Man, that's a good dunk right there. Washington gets two back on the other end.
Pretty quick response. You know, a couple of times in this game, Golden State has showed you the type of ball they like to play, and that was one of them. They score 3 seconds after you score.
Brown.
Look at Jason Maxfield attack the glass. comes again with a running start. It will elevate from out of nowhere. The putback put down.
That is something special around the rim. The final score is Sports Ultimate Nightly Highlight Show. Tonight, get a complete recap from out in the NBA, the NHL, and the latest from spring training. It is the final score tonight at 11 on Fox Sports Detroit. Bynum inside to Aflalo, and Aaron Aflalo gives the Pistons a 91-72 lead. He has 9. And Don Nelson will take a timeout. 7:04 to play. Will Bynum with a setup here. Aaron Aflalo with a finish. I want to give some play to my man, Orlando Charleston, at the bell. Just a nice fan.
Yep. Thrilled to be here.
Yeah. Yo, it was a, the husband celebrated. Yo, I screwed that up. I got to go back and do it right. I might as well. My bad. They haven't been married 60 years, only alive 60 years. We'll do the Marine Corps leader of the game, and then I'll do it. Who would the Marines like as their leader of the game tonight for the Pistons? Yeah, you're right. Jason Maxiel. He is our U.S. Marine Corps leader of the game.
I can't argue that at all, George. The way he has been powering it up against the Golden State Warriors. A little bit of extra effort there. Another alley-oop feed, throw down.
A lot of thumpers tonight for Jason Maxiel, our U.S. Marine Corps leader of the game. 14 points, 9 rebounds, 6 of them in the offensive end. Well, I had a bad turnover tonight. Dean Hartley is celebrating his 60th birthday tonight. The couple's not celebrating their 60th wedding anniversary. I hope someday you will, Dean and Sally, but happy birthday, Dean. Well, he's still a young man.
Well, 60's a new 50.
That's right. The jumper. He has 11. 6:40 to play. Nice strike by Watson. Knocked it out of bounds. Pistons 91, Golden State 74. The Pistons will win their 4th in a row here tonight and head to Atlanta. And then come home to entertain Orlando on Monday. Your binding shot won't drop. Ball with the drop. It's the 3. Randolph saved the rebound nicely for Watson. Jamal Crawford. Aaron Aflalo. Crawford with a fadeaway. Fills it up. You may have heard Jamal Crawford scored 50 in December at Charlotte. He has 22 here tonight. Good trade. Will Bynum lays it up and lays it in.
You know, Will Bynum is getting better because he's playing better under control. You know, coming into this game, last two games, George, no turnovers. And he said he hasn't hit himself tonight, just one.
Crawford found him, and Morrow with the hoop has 13. 93-78. Pistons with the lead, just under five to play. Will Bynum deep in the lane to Kwame Brown. Crawford fouled on the shot try. Anthony Randolph called for the foul. Another reminder for you, tomorrow night's game in Atlanta will be carried on Fox Sports Detroit Plus. Coverage starts at 6:30 with Pistons Insider. Some of these Fox Sports Plus channel numbers are listed here. For a complete list, go to foxsports.com/Detroit. Pistons basketball on Fox Sports Detroit Plus, presented by Bell Tire. Comcast 901, 88, and a lot of others. That's a game for you tomorrow night. It'll be a good one. A free throw for Kwame. One for two. 94-78. No shot is long. Walter Herman with a rebound. Walter Herman will bind him. Jason Maxey and Kwame and Aaron Aflalo on the floor. Jason has 16.
You know, you might be tempted to say he's been in the right place, right time tonight, but I don't think that's, you know, just a coincidence, George. He is moving so well, anticipating. He's where the ball is by design.
He's working hard and using his head. Mistake by Golden State. The offensive foul on Anthony Randolph. Take another look at the charge here.
Tommy able to square his shoulders perfectly. That was an easy call there.
Draws the foul.
On Aaron Aflalo.
Second. Aaron Aflalo with a second foul.
Traffic. Finish with the left hand. Once again, under control. Not running anybody over. Not turning it over.
Jamal Crawford has 25. Pistons 98. Golden State 81, Aaron Aflalo falls. Got it anyway. Just it to Walter Herman and missed it. Will Bynum with the offensive board. Walter in the post against Watson. Nice dish inside, and he got a near chance to the hoop. 3 minutes left. Watson with a shot and he sticks it.
Watson.
He can shoot on the move.
Time out,
Michael
Detroit.
Curry will take a 20-second timeout. With 2:48 to play. And that'll go to a full timeout for Golden State. Watch Walter Herman find Amir for the hoop as the Pistons hit the century mark. to score in the other game. To play at the Palace. 100-83. Golden State. And our Bud Light play of the game. That Jason Maxfield jam, Greg.
I can see that again and again. The bench loved it. Look at Sheed. He got a charge out of it. Oh, yeah. But Jason's ferocity really just part of what the Pistons were able to do as a team tonight, George. They were dominant in every way, in every stat, in every category. Looking forward to tomorrow night.
Now into the Detroit lineup. 42, Walter.
There's our man, Walter Sharp. So glad to see him out there on the floor.
Walter Sharp on the floor. Here's Greg Say. Keeps it inside for Amir. Taken away by Davidson. Campbell back to shot.
Yeah, Jamie!
Davidson, Davidson scores and draws the contact and the foul.
Foul Amir Johnson.
Well, this time the Pistons unable to stop the basketball until Davidson was already into his move. He did a nice job of being strong with the basketball, protecting it, and he'll get an and one for his efforts.
This is the free throw. Walter Hammond with a rebound. Here's Hammond with a dribble. He hits it. Vitamin double victory. Crawford misses. Walter Hermann with a rebound. Only a minute and 48 to play. Walter shot
down. Walter!
And score!
Walter shot!
He's in the long strides.
Everybody has scored.
Yep, able to reverse it on the other side. Really enjoyed working with him, George, spending time with him. With some of the segments for his pregame show. Nice young man.
Yeah, he's worked hard this year, and he's improved.
Able to fill a lot of space there with that length and the long strides.
And here Johnson popped up on the line. Collected the ball and then himself and laid it in. And that shot won't go. Alley-oop to Amir from Will Bynum. After the block by Amir.
Timeout
Golden State with 107 to play. Warriors will take a 20. This is for the 108-85 lead. Look at this throwdown by Amir.
Let's go, Chris.
the athletic trainer for Golden State, helping Anthony Randolph to the bench. We do have the brothers Adenauer at it tonight, and Mike Adenauer is winning in a runaway. Hey, the Knicks visit the Palace this Wednesday on Feed the Children Telethon night. There's a great offer on the web. You can get seats to the game and contribute to the telethon. Go to Pistons.com or call our famous phone number, 248-377-0100. Bellinelli misses. Here, trying to hand out to the Pistons, but it will be Golden State's basketball. Less than a minute to play. Crawford shot. Bellinelli followed. And he fills it up. Bellinelli with 11. And Walter Sharp pushed him down. And Walter will be called for the foul. Pistons in the penalty. So Curtis will go to the line.
Pistons will try to run after this game, George, for Atlanta. But Atlanta playing at Charlotte tonight will have to do a little bit of traveling themselves. So both teams will be coming in as part of a back-to-backer tomorrow night.
They didn't travel as far to try to add all this up. Plus, they started at 7, not 8.
Right.
But there at least is something to be said for the other guys playing out of town. Both those free throws. Make it 108-89. 22 seconds left. Pistons shot clock at 7. Will find it. Misfires. Bellinelli with the ball for the Golden State Warriors. Seconds to play.
They have some issues of their own, you know, and Mike Bibby, who has played so well for them this year, not playing at his normal pace right now. Josh Smith struggling. In fact, had a stretch very recently where he missed, get this, 10 straight free throws.
We'll see what happens in Atlanta. They're still a very good young team. Both free throws go for Bellinelli. Will Bynum will hang on to it. And the Pistons will win.